So, welcome to Mardi Gras World on this incredibly beautiful day. I want to recognize, I'm excited to be here for you guys as you walked in today. You might see we just finished a new statue of my dad, Blaine Kern, and you'll see as you're walking out. And I want to recognize my sons Fitz and Patrick that are here today, the fourth generation working in this family business, current to this crazy business that we're in. You know, we live in an incredible city that is loved the world over for our culture of incredible food, music, and celebration. You know, and I've had the great fortune in my lifetime, you know, of traveling that this world that we live in with my father and basically selling the way that we celebrate to the rest of the world. Everybody wants to copy and wants to emulate what we do in this city. You know, and it's easy for those of us that live here to sometimes, you know, we may get down on ourselves. You know, crime does this, and, you know, we've got this, we have issues, we have challenges. Well, you know, we're dealing with the same challenges that the rest of the world is dealing with. The only difference is that we're living in a place that everybody else would like to live. And that's the truth. People love this city. You say New Orleans and their eyes light up and they smile and they'll say Mardi Gras and they'll talk about the food. They'll talk about the great music. 5 years ago, and this is the reason why we're here today, my friend Greg Fearn, the CEO of LCMC, which has done a lot of incredible work here in New Orleans and in the state, he invited me to lunch with John Nickens here, the CEO of Children's Hospital. And what was really interesting about it was is that he was bringing John, who's literally a superstar from Houston, Texas, at the Houston Children's, to New Orleans. And normally, as you guys all know, it's normally people from New Orleans that are leaving, going off to other places. Well, here we had Greg bringing in the top guy in his business to basically make a statement and do something incredible for New Orleans and creating a world-class children's hospital at a level that frankly puts us in the top echelons, not only in this country, but in the world. And at that lunch, I had a chance to, and I'm thinking that maybe Greg invited me because he wanted somebody that, like, you know, loved the city, was excited, had a lot of passion for things, and spending time with John, I could see that he has that same kind of energy. And anyway, we talked about something that I'll tell you about, and I explained to them in the meeting, and we talked about the city and probably about 1,000 different things. But one of the things we talked about was the great successes that we, Kern Studios, have had in participating in parades and celebrations in other cities around the United States that were nationally televised. And one particular story was at the top of my list because it was the top of what we happened to have going on at that time. In Nashville, Tennessee, the guy who ran tourism there, who created Music City, was approached by a lady that worked for the marketing team that ran a local Christmas parade there in the city that had gone on for 70 years. But it was the kind of parade that we see everywhere but New Orleans in most cases. It was like people had their pickup trucks and trailers, right? And it was a kind of a mom and pop type of a thing. And basically this lady from this company that was sponsoring the Nashville, this Christmas parade, said, "We want you to help us with some money and help improve the parade." And this guy who was from Louisiana or had worked in Louisiana in the CVB in Baton Rouge, he said, "Look," he said, "if you're going to do something like this, you have to. If you can get the Kerns involved from New Orleans and bring in some world-class, some great floats, then we will work with you guys and we'll help you out." And literally within 2 years, not only did we bring a great parade to that city, but what we also did, and we did it in partnership with the Monroe Carroll Children's Hospital in Nashville, and we were able to bring in a television show locally and nationally, and also we literally won an Emmy Award for the parade itself and for the coverage of the parade, which was really impressive. And in that conversation, John said to me, man, that is just, you know, he thought that was like really so cool. He said, you know, one day we need to do something like that here in New Orleans. Well, here we are 5 years later. This guy and the team at Children's have done an incredible job of building the new campus down there. For you guys, please get down and check it out. And we have a chance to create a parade in New Orleans that will have local television, national television coverage, but also world-class in terms of the types of props and figures, and frankly, floats not just typical to what you see here in New Orleans, but the pageant-style small floats especially made for this Christmas parade. And I'm just so happy to be partnered with John and with the DDD, and he can explain some more. It's been a whole team have really come together to make this happen, and it couldn't have happened, frankly, without John and the partners at Children's, but also without the work of the DDD, French Market Corporation, everyone coming together and helping us out. Anyway, John. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Barry. My name is John Nickens. I have the privilege to serve as the president and CEO of Children's Hospital. And I love reflecting and hearing Barry tell that story of lunch. I had never been to Mardi Gras. I didn't know what a parade really was. But I sat there and watched his enthusiasm and his energy, and I was like, yes, I want a part of that. Over the last 5 years, I've fallen in love with the city of New Orleans, state of Louisiana, and it's the people. And some of my comments are really to say thank you to the people who have been instrumental for Children's Hospital the last 5 years. We've invested $300 million into becoming a top children's hospital. We believe a top city needs a top children's hospital, and we want to make you proud in the way that we care for the next generation of kids. You know, I'm grateful for Kern Studios. I'm grateful for the Downtown Development District, and I'm excited that today we're talking about a Children's Hospital Holiday Parade. And what is that? Well, I'll start with just why. Well, our mission at Children's Hospital is to create a generation of health, an opportunity for a brighter future for kids. To doctors and nurses every day commit to healing sick children. But it's also about creating environments of health. How do we create the next generation of a healthy environment? And we know at the hospital that play and fun is a big part of kids' therapy. It helps with resilience. It helps them in the healing process. We know that kids overall, it's holistic. It's mental, it's emotional, it's physical, and kids can struggle. This is an opportunity for us to celebrate that journey, the process, and I'm incredibly excited to be partnered with these guys. You know, what is it? What is this parade? Well, you heard about Nashville. This is gonna be bigger and brighter and better than Nashville. We're in New Orleans, it has to if it's a parade. This is the Children's Hospital Holiday Parade that I think will be spectacular, family-centered, celebrating kids. And I'll tell you, for me, this is an opportunity for us to say thank you to the city of New Orleans and for everything that you've done over the years for Children's Hospital. In a way, this is our gift back to New Orleans, and we look forward to celebrating together in this season. I do want to pause and offer some thanks. You know, it wouldn't happen without our sponsors. The idea that the Development District has invited us in and partnered is really amazing. It's a sign and shows the humility of New Orleanians to work together. You don't see that in every city. I'm excited to say thank you to LSU Health Science Center, Tulane School of Medicine, LCMC Health, our parent company, Chick-fil-A's long-term sponsor, Heart Gifts, a sweet little nonprofit. Miracle League is where we bring kids with special needs together with healthy kids, and they go out to sporting events together, and then kids join the fight. And all proceeds from this event will go toward Walker's Imaginarium. It's a really a spectacular moment in time. It will be a change for New Orleans and for our hospital for generations. The sponsors, Downtown Development District, French Market Corporation, NewOrleans.com, WDSU, Audacity Radio, Louisiana Feed Your Soul. I kind of love that, just feed your soul. World War II Museum, the Convention Center, and B1 Bank. Their generosity supports the mission of Children's Hospital, and this couldn't happen without them. So for a guy who didn't grow up in New Orleans, been here almost 5 years, to think a parade to kick off the holiday season to celebrate Children's like only New Orleans can do, wow, exciting times. I now get the opportunity and privilege to turn it over to Davon Barber, who's the CEO and president for Downtown Development District. Been here about a year. He's a game changer. He is going to be a driver of what the opportunity for us to grow commerce in New Orleans looks like. He brings ideas, and I'm incredibly proud to partner with him on this parade. Davon.
Good morning, everyone. It's so great to see you. As John stated, I'm Davon Barbour, President and CEO of the Downtown Development District. The Downtown Development District is a special improvement district. We were created back in 1974, and our mission, simply put, is to curate one of the greatest downtowns in America. We curate a place where you live, work, and play. And so we are thrilled, we are excited to be at the table, to be a partner with John and also Current Studios in this endeavor. As they've stated, the world knows New Orleans and our hospitality. And so this event really is an opportunity for us, again, to showcase our great community. For years, the Downtown Development District has produced a holiday event. And so, you know, sometimes when we get in our daily routine, it takes a moment to just reflect and think about how can we make this even bigger and better. Much of our work isn't done just simply alone. It's through collaboration and partnership. And so we saw this as a true opportunity, again, to elevate this experience, to create something, again, that's game-changing, that really continues to celebrate New Orleans. And so we are thrilled, excited to be at the table for this endeavor. Again, we produce events, we are in hospitality, but moreover, this event for us, it's not only about community building, it's also about providing an economic boost for our businesses. New Orleans, we are a community of small businesses, and so this is also an opportunity for you to celebrate all the businesses along the commercial corridors that are located along the parade route within downtown as well. Give them a little bit of love. We know that the holiday season is all about commerce, and so I do have a few stats that I just want to share with you to, again, reinforce the importance of events like this and its impact on our small business community. So one organization, a major retail organization called ICSC, recently did a holiday consumer survey, and they found that 90% of adults intend on making holiday purchases. Again, this is a great opportunity to support all of our small businesses, our restaurants that are out there. Take advantage when you're enjoying the parade, when you have downtime, go visit those businesses. ICSC also indicates that they're predicting a 9.9% increase in spending as it relates to restaurants. You heard Barry talk about the restaurants and why people love New Orleans. Again, this is an opportunity for you. You're going to need to get off your feet. You're going to be jumping. You're going to be shouting as you see these incredible floats. But again, take some time, recharge, refuel, replenish those calories. Support those restaurants that are out there. And then finally, 57% of shoppers intend to support brick and mortar stores. So again, we want you ahead of the parade, go online, check out some of those businesses, and again, take the time to visit these small businesses that depend upon you and that drive our economy. So this is an incredible opportunity. Again, this parade is going to be like nothing we've seen before, and we all know that no one throws a spectacle like Current Studio. So we are thrilled to be in this partnership. And so with that, I'm going to pass the baton to my good friend and colleague, Kelly Schultz, Senior Vice President of Communications and PR at New Orleans & Company.
Thanks, Davon. Good morning, y'all. On behalf of everyone at New Orleans & Company, we say hello and happy holidays. We're so excited to be part of this parade. If you think about the tourism industry in New Orleans, we all know what an incredible economic driver that is. And we come to work every day at New Orleans & Company to drive that economy and to bring business to the restaurants and the musicians and the artists and everyone who makes their living when we have a thriving cultural economy. We started 2022 off in a pretty strong way. If you think back, you know, having the All-State Sugar Bowl, having Mardi Gras parades roll through the streets again, thank goodness. We had the Final Four. Our spring festivals returned with Jazz Fest and French Quarter Fest. Then we went right into a strong summer season where we saw the return of Essence and all of these wonderful staples on our calendar that we've not been able to do in person for so long because of COVID. All of these events are back. And so this fall, the city's doing very well. I just drove down Convention Center Boulevard. You probably noticed that it is bustling with activity. We are honored to be able to get these big conventions back in our city. We've had 10,000 anesthesiologists here. We have hosted the world's largest gathering of cancer researchers anywhere in the world since COVID. They came to New Orleans for their meeting. So tourism is coming back, conventions are coming back, and this holiday parade is a nice way to end the year, what has been a really strong year, and the resurgence of face-to-face events and creating those cultural experiences that we can only do here in New Orleans. So we will be marketing this through neworleans.com, our website. We'll also be marketing it through the Holidays New Orleans program, Holidays New Orleans style, which includes the Revillon dinners, the Papa Noel hotel rates. There's all kinds of initiatives to get people out into our stores. There's something new this year called Museum Store Sunday. So you think about all of our amazing museums here, they all have gift shops. We want people to go out and make some holiday purchases in those gift shops. So our economy is coming back strong, and this is a great opportunity for us to promote the city, promote this parade, and let people know that New Orleans is a family-friendly destination for them to come enjoy the holidays. So I'm now going to turn it over to our friend and partner, Lisa Alexis, who directs the Mayor's Cultural Economy Office. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Kelly. Good morning, everyone. And I just want to say on behalf of Mayor LaToya Cantrell, we are truly excited. We have started the year off with a huge economic stimulus, and now we are going to wrap the year very strong as we did in the beginning. Thanks to Barry Kern, Kern Studios, Children's Hospital, Downtown Development District, and New Orleans and Company. I am so thrilled to be a part of this economic, cultural tourism driver. And I'd just like to say, as Kelly mentioned, all of the events we've had this year, I'd like to share that each event, festival, just engagement that we've had here is reporting economically to have been stronger at times than it was in 2019 pre-pandemic. So we are really standing up and putting our legs under us in a strong way. So I encourage you all, please, let's finish this year strong by supporting our local economy. And I'd just like to say, let's continue to embrace the culture because it drives our local economy and it will create generational prosperity for our citizens of New Orleans. So let's get out, shop, merchandise, and support the culture. Thank you.
So I just have a couple more things to say. First of all, probably the most important thing is that for this parade that my son Fitz brought I have a new granddaughter, 4 months old, named Virginia. So I'm sure that this parade will be very I'll be very popular a year or so from now, maybe next year's parade when she knows what's going on. But also, I want to mention there's going to be helium balloons in the parade besides the incredible floats that we're going to put on the streets. And it's not the typical floats that you see in our Mardi Gras parades. We're going to have these monumental props like this. We've got a three-story tall Santa Claus that we've built that we're working with the DDD and Devon to find a spot downtown where we'll have this. It's going to be absolutely incredible. We've got these great nutcrackers, and we've built just a whole cadre of incredible Christmas props that you'll see around town. We have a beautiful sleigh and reindeer that are going down to Children's Hospital to the main campus there. And there's going to be a lot of things for people to see that'll be installations, not just the parade, but installations for the entire Christmas and holiday season. And the after party. The parade will end. It starts off where we do the Crew of Boo Parade. Starts off at Esplanade in Decatur or North Peters,
goes through the French Quarter, up Canal Street, Canal to Barone, Barone to Julia Street, and Julia to St. Charles, and it ends at Lafayette Square. And at Lafayette Square, in conjunction with the city and the DDD, we're going to have an after party, a holiday after party, which is going to have some of these great props. We've got Rebirth, as well as other entertainment. We'll have some food trucks out there, and some of our partners will have activation. So all this has come together very quickly. Somebody said, well, Barry, how can you make a decision? How can you guys make a decision? In fact, John walked into my office. It wasn't that many months ago. Only in New Orleans could we pull something like this together. And frankly, it's very exciting. And I believe it's the only way to do it. Jump into it. We're going to have a lot of fun. And the city is going to be very, very proud to have this. The people that come to town. And we're going to get some great coverage around the country. Thank you all very much.